Corsair TX750M power supply. Let's see what's in here. PSU, power supply unit, right? So the plastic is very important to be over this. Again, I ordered this from Corsair. This is the motherboard that I'm putting in the build, which is the B450 Pro Wi-Fi ATX. But we're here to talk about the power supply unit, which is very important that you get the power supply suitable for your build, so that you get enough power and you don't ignite and blow yourself up, right? So off the back, again, if you know me and you know Tech for Rec Warpath, which is my name, you know that I'm very big on the packaging. Corsair, I love their brand for their color. Yellow and black is two of my favorite colors, and red, of course. And you're going to get to know that. Again, this is a tricky opening, right? Like the other ones. So let's see. They always have like a pull-out opening, Corsair. So I like the way they set their stuff up. I find that very cool. Again, look. Oh, wow. They got that opening like before. You heard? I get excited. Boop. So off top, very durable packaging from Corsair. So we have the manual here, important information, right? Honestly, who reads this stuff? Stop putting this in there. Now it's important for people. So this is a semi-module built, right? Meaning it has the connectors separated from the actual power supply unit. These are all the SATA connections, the PCI. I don't know why it has a hole already in it, but this is the cable cord, very durable power cord. And this is, oh, the nice foam, black. That's cool right there. I like that. I'll keep that and use it for something else. Facts. You're going to hear facts a lot from me on all my shows. By the way, check us out on The Lockout. It's our other show where I talk about myself and my stories from being in the streets, Rikers Island, gangs, and changing my life and doing things like this today. So, let me know if you ever had this power supply by Corsair semi-module. Just means that all those connectors and SATA cables and all that are not connected to the back. They out in order to make it a little easier for you when connecting your build, and you only use the cabling or the connectors and pins that is needed and suitable for your board, right? I love the way it's not mustard cables, it's just the black ones, right? So that's cool. So let me know if you ever had this one, the 750, TX750M. Was it quiet? Is it loud? I seen it in a few places. I wanted to get the RGB one, of course. Nothing is more important than RGB, right? I know that much. So again, let me know if you had it. How was it for you? Did you like it or what? If I'm not mistaken, this was this way, yeah. So basically, that's what comes in the box. And of course, you got these, the zip ties. You can never have enough zip ties and a few screws that you're going to need to put this in your case, right? And the power cord, of course, we're going to put this right back. And I'm pretty sure if you've been around, you know what all these connectors is for, right? So you have a bunch of them here. Some you're going to use type 4 cable and all that. Some of them you're going to use. A lot of them you're not going to use. So semi is always good. And that's why I went with the semi. So like that, I don't have to have extra cords connected. And the the other one, to be honest, the one that comes with the cables connected, it is very it's cheaper, way cheaper. I paid $100 and something for this one. To be honest, I think it was $140 something, $150. Probably because based on the fact that the prices right now are sky high, based on the fact that there's a shortage of supplies for PC builds, for building your own PC, right? And even buying a pre-built is being hard for some companies. There's a list for a lot of them. For I think it's iBuy or something like that, the company, iGame, something, I don't know. Leave in the comments if you know iBuy, I think it is. Something like that. But anyway, they have a list. And not that I was going to order a pre-built or, you know, however, I've always planned on building my own PC. Because I know from experience and watching content and dealing with a lot of tech guys and guys that do all this type of content and want to have the best PCs and the fastest PCs available, that we don't buy pre-built. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. It's like you frowned upon, right, in this game. Leave in the comments if that's facts. But I seen a kid that bought a pre-built or built computer already, right, for those that don't understand. And he had 4 million something views. Now, we all know views at times mean nothing. It just means somebody watched and they could have got right off. Watch time is important. Team watch time, you already know. And subscriber count, which I love all my real subscribers. Subscribe, hit like, dislike, what have you. But if you ever thought about making content like this or any type of podcasting or what have you, just know that some people feel, oh, they have 500,000 subscribers, 90,000 subscribers, and they lit, right? Subscribers are overrated. Most people that watch all this content are not even subscribed to the channels. If you notice, some people have 30,000, 25,000, 90,000 subscribers, and you can't get 2,000 views to save your life. And it's cool. We all working on progression, right? This is not a competition, right? This is not a race. If it was, a lot of people lost a long time ago, bro. By the way, check us out on iHeartRadio, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iTunes, Overcast, Radio Public, Pandora, wherever you watch your audio podcasting at, look us up on The Lockout. And On The Lockout is our other YouTube channel. On The Lockout, everything. Follow me on Instagram, On The Lockout.